Hello, and welcome to FM Corner. I'm Danny Koontz. Today's topic that we're going to speak about is the decision that facility managers have to make many times. Do I repair a piece of equipment, or do I replace a piece of equipment? First thing you should do is in thinking about replacing a piece of equipment is obviously you're probably going to have a quote for what the repair is going to be. So you have the repair number, and you also have the number of what the replacement item is going to cost when it's new. So then first thing is to take a look at some of the factors. What is the age of that piece of equipment? What is the condition it's in? What is the expected lifetime of that piece of equipment, and how old is it? In other words, it's a 7 to 8 year timeline for a piece, and it's been in your location for 10 years. Would lean more to it's probably time to think about replacing it. What is that cost going to be in comparison to a new unit? One of the things that I always looked at was using a 50% rule. If everything else was even, and the cost to repair the unit was more than 50% of the price of the new unit, I look to purchase a new unit. You have to think about, is it an owned property, or do we lease the property? What kind of timeline is left on the lease? It's a restaurant maybe that was doing very well. Now it's struggling because of where it's located, something like that. And sales are going down, and the lease is going to expire in 2 to 3 years. That might be a location where you tend to repair versus replace because of the short term of the lease. But you have to quickly look at each of those figures. You also have to understand the pack line, profit after controllables. Is your managers in the restaurant, is the R&M line above the pack line, which means it's part of their bonus program? Or is it below the pack line, which means it technically has no input or impact on their business? It's a function of facilities and their budget. Because the reason for that is operations is going to give you much more input on what they think the decision will be when part of that money is part of their budget. Is it going to be a repair, or is it going to be capitalized? What are the capitalization rules of your company? If you're doing a one-time major rebuild, some companies allow that to be capitalized. Thus, operations, it's not a big deal to them because it comes out as added to their depreciation schedule. So you need to know those factors prior to when you're going to make that decision. You also have to look at things like abuse. Do you have a particular general manager or location that has a tendency or a reputation to abuse equipment? If you do, buying them a new piece is not necessarily going to help them because they're going to abuse it as well. You might want to look at doing the repair versus purchasing a new piece. So abuse is a factor. Another factor that plays into play is think about if you purchase new, the warranty savings that you may get. You may get a piece of equipment that's fryer and the tank has 5 years full and 5 years prorated warranty on it. You may get 2 years parts and labor. That's a lot of money that for straight warranty calls, you're not going to be paying as a company. So you need to factor that into what the purchase price is before you do that. And then the last piece to think about, what are the circumstances? If I'm managing a location located at the Daytona 500, and it happens to be 10 days prior to the race, and they have an issue of a piece of equipment down, if I can't get a new piece of equipment there prior to the race, then I have no choice but to move toward the repair. Whether it's the best business decision long-term or not, it is certainly the best business decision for that particular time frame because I have to have that piece of equipment up and running for the upcoming race as it comes through. One other thing to think about is talk to your vendors and kind of have some unwritten rules to the vendor that says, when you are quoting out this price, if it gets to a certain number, I want to make sure I'm alerted about it so I'll know quickly about whether I want to repair or replace the equipment. So give your vendors the opportunity with information that you provide for them on what you want to know about to help you make that decision. At the end of the day, the decision has to be made quickly. You can't say, I'm going to think about it for 4 or 5 days. I need to make a decision right now. Get it fixed or get it replaced. Take all the information that I just explained, put that together quickly, and then make the best informed decision that you can. Will you miss on some pieces? Absolutely. But again, you're working off more wins than losses. There will be opportunities that you should have done one thing and you did the other. It's the nature of the business. The worst thing you want to do is leave your restaurant out there hanging without any kind of clear definition on what's going to be done. Something is better than nothing. So again, in repair versus replacement, look at all the factors that come into play about that particular restaurant, that particular piece of equipment, history, age, location, lease, capitalization, all those factors, and then try to make the best business decision for the company that you can. That's episode 1 of Repair and Replacement. Thank you for listening and look forward to seeing you next time.